Good morning, and I welcome you all to the 10th day's program of the 93rd Annual Conference of the Music Academy, Madras. I now invite Dr. T.S. Sathyavathi, who is perhaps one of the greatest scholars whom we have in our midst, and who has been a recipient of the Musicologist Award of the Music Academy, Madras, and who is also a member of the Experts Committee of the Music Academy, and a disciple of Sri RK Srikantan, to please take forward this presentation. As requested by you, I will give you the full time without cutting any of
it. Thank you.
Yontah pravishya mama vajamimam prasuptam sanjeevayatya khila shakti dhara swadhamna anyamscha hasta charana shravana twagadin pranamamo bhagavate purushaya tubhyam.
Namasadase namasadasaspataye. My very sincere pranams to the discerning audience here. And hearty congratulations to the Sangita Kalanidhi designate, the most highly talented musician of our country, Dr. Soumya. I am grateful to the Academy, Sri Murali sir and Sri Sriram, for giving this very unique and I should say proud privilege of presenting a program on the musical personality of my guru, Sangita Kalanidhi, Padma Bhushana awardee, the legendary Vidwan R.K. Srikantan. I really don't know where to begin and how to end, how to go on, because it's a Himalayan achievement. It is going to be a Herculean task for me. Since it's a tribute, with all my humility, I shall offer it at his lotus feet. He was born on the Makara Sankranti day, 14th January, 1920. So his life was a Sangita Sankranti. Went on and on distributing beautiful music across the globe without any reservation. And the sacred river flowing through this tiny hamlet, Rudrapatna. Rudrapatna is on the banks of river Kaveri, and it has not only made the fields on her banks, she has not only made the fields on her banks fertile for vegetation, but she has raised a very rich crop of scholars, poets, philosophers, and a host of musicians. This village, small village as I said, it breathes music through the whistling wind, the sighing reed, the gentle brook, the cooing cuckoo, the buzzing bee, all become a part of this natural opera in Rudrapatna. And in the smoldering atmosphere of music that my guru was born, to the blessed couple Sannaka and Krishna Shastri. His siblings also, you might have noted, his eldest brother Vidwan Venkatarama Shastri, whose grandson we have amidst us, Sriram Kumar, Vidwan Sriram Kumar, and another brother, Vidwan Narayana Swami, his sons, the famous Rudrapatnam brothers, and also Dr. R. N. Srilata, and another brother, an English professor, a great Vidwan and scholar, Vidwan R. K. Ramanathan. My guru had his initial training in music from his eldest brother, Venkatrama Shastri, and later on honed up his musical abilities on his own and formed a bani, which later on came to be called as RKS Bani. There are certain very, very characteristic features about his bani. He served All India Radio on the staff. He was there for 35 years. And this gave him a very apt exposure, such an exposure, wide exposure, that he imbibed all best things from the greatest stalwarts of those days. He had highest regard for Mysore Chikkaram Rao, Mysore Vasudevachar, Ariyakudi Ramanujayengar, Musri Subramanyaya. He always used to remember them. And Shamangudi Mama, of course, he kept on saying he has learnt a lot from Shamangudi sir. So this is the kind of acquisition, amassing of musical knowledge, the treasure that my guru was so keen on, so intent through his life. He was a learner, he considered himself a learner. And sometimes I used to wonder why he is saying all this. Amma, next janmatakana enak nalla sangeet varanu. At least next janma. I used to say, sir, please don't say that before me. If it is next janma for you, how many more janmas we should wait? At least 100 janmas then. So that's the kind of humility he had. And his career, I mean, no other musician I remember to have traveled from east to west in the USA at the age of 90, performing at 17 places in a period of 2 months. So his musical career is spanning over 7 decades. He has performed at every sabha. Mention any sabha of repute anywhere in the country and outside, he would have spread the aroma of beautiful Carnatic music. And he performed his last concert here at the academy in the year 2011, just 3 years before he passed away. And without much ado, I shall take a plunge into his musical career and his musical personality, which is very unique, very special. Not just because I belong to that parampara. Sarva kantam atmiyam pashyati, no doubt about it. Everybody thinks that whatever belongs to oneself is very charming. That apart, even if I come out of my own place, I can see the brilliance of his music. What strikes one at the very first instance when one hears RKS music is his voice, no doubt about it. It is resonant, it is deep, it is vibrant, it is powerful, it is sonorous with clarity and purity. People wonder whether he became a Srikantha because he was named so, or the parents named him Srikantha because even as he when he cried as an infant, it was very melodious. Bana says, Kancha Krenkar, that Kaneer of Kamsya Krenkara. Kamsya is bronze. If you scratch bronze on a hard surface, the sound that gives. And you can also compare it to the twang of a bowstring. That's the kind of that kaneer that his voice carries. and there is not a dull moment in his performance anywhere, because the voice itself is so arresting and captivating and filling. Once he just holds on to that shajja, the mantra shajja, the hall is full with that vibration. So it becomes easy for the audience to be carried with him. We have chosen a few audio and video clips. You should please pardon us, because it may fall short of your expectations, the quality. Quality of audio and video, I cannot assure you, but still. And we have done a lot of editing also, just to serve the purpose today. We have cut off the rest of the things, only whatever is relevant to the present program, we have retained them. And it is Shruti Leena, his voice. Every note is discernible, that kind of a crystal clear pronunciation, that uccharana. Maybe or may not be he has studied the uccharana, that is the shiksha shastra, but every syllable that he utters, it is produced from the point that it has to be produced according to the shiksha shastra. Every note. The raga delineation. First, we are taking the raga. He is known for brevity of expression. It is like we say in economics, minimum expenditure and maximum benefit. So with just a few strokes, like great things are always represented in a very simple manner. That's why we say simply grand. It should be simple, at the same time, grand. Like a Krishna, if you want to draw him, just draw two lines and holes and one peacock feather. That is Krishna. You don't have to draw full body of Krishna. Likewise, Gandhiji, just one arch and one spectacles, finished. So great things. Likewise, every raga, my guru brings out in the very first phrase, and any 5 seconds of his delineation of the raga, you listen to it, the raga comes alive with its full essence coming in every note. Now, samples of that.
La 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 la.
Running. strokes. As I said, very few strokes. Okay, very few phrases. I am reminded of that Puranic story wherein Subramanya and Ganesha, they have a contest of going round the universe thrice to get a fruit from Narada Maharshi. Immediately, Skanda sets out on his Mayura Vahana. He goes on with two rounds. He finishes the two rounds. Ganesha is happily seated next to his parents. And the third round, when he is about to close, Ganesha is already eating the fruit. How did he do it? He just went, circumambulated his parents thrice. By the time he went round the earth, he circumambulated his parents and he said, they are the universe. They are. That is how. So whatever takes a lot of time or effort, with my guru it took very minimum effort and maximum effect. That is the motto. He did not do it deliberately. It was not a deliberate, intentional indulgence. It just happened. That was his style. His style is marked by that. And voice, I said, voice cannot be acquired. This is one thing we must all remember, because Manasollasakara very beautifully says this, Anya Janma Krita Abhyasat, Anya Janma Krita Abhyasat, Jnana Yogat, Shivarchanat, Shariram Prapyate Punyaihi, Abhyasan Naiva Labhyate. I don't have to translate it. It is by birth, it is along with born. That is why sharirena sahajatam ityeva shariram iti kathyate. It is born along with the body. You can at the most refine it, hone it up, culture it, polish it. If it is not musical, sorry, it is not musical. It cannot produce any music. So some improvement is possible, but that basic, something that is inherent and innate to a person, that voice is something God-given. And my guru was blessed to have one of the best voices in the field. And then we have the Kala Pramanam. So we have, I have to say a few things about the Kala Pramanam. It is neither fast nor slow. It is neither vilamba nor druta. It is always in the middle tempo. Again, he found it very, very attractive and convenient and comfortable with himself and the audience for his music, his type of music. I never say this is ideal. That is his. It is only a darshana of his music, not a pradarshana. Every great musician is great in his own way. So, the Kala Pramana. But Naradiya Shiksha of 7th century AD, he mentions very clearly that while learning from a guru, one has to learn it in a slow tempo, vilamba. Because to understand every nuance, every delicate flourish, the contours of the raga and the gamakas, auchitya, purna prayoga of the gamakas, one has to learn it slowly. While practicing at home, he has to do it the fastest he can, with clarity, not jeopardizing the melody or whatever, the content. While presenting, it should be the middle tempo. This is said by Naradiya Shiksha. So middle tempo is ideal, is what is said. And RKS sir always presented all the compositions in a very, very majestic gait. And that Kala Pramana used to be maintained from A to Z, beginning to end. Never he used to hurry up, rush up in between or anywhere while presenting the composition. Now we have one or two examples of that.
Varavai na
It's a royal darbar. It's a royal assembly. Observed by now how the sahitya is uttered with precision, with clarity. Every akshara syllable is heard. So it is very easy. It is so beautifully blended, soaked in bhava. It comes to us along with the meaning, meaning not again a very deliberately pronounced or articulated thing. It comes so naturally. And he had such rare gems in his treasure of compositions. Such rare gems. Very rare gems. All of which he very meticulously collected over decades. From big stalwarts. He used to tell us very often how he has striven to take one script from Alathur brothers. Or one script from Shamungudi Mama. And he used to like treasure them like anything. It was a coveted possession of his. And he was very possessive about the scripts. Very possessive. Because that is the carrier of our music. The notated, perfectly notated compositions in Carnatic music, they are the carriers of our music for generations. So he treasured them with utmost care, and even till the last days we could see him seated happily in the chair in the front room, surrounded by books, with a script in his hand. Always ready to learn, always learning, always with a script. And the rare composition, one of the rare compositions we are playing now, Lalitambika of Dikshitar in Devakriya.
Lalitambika Chindayamyagam Lalitambika Chindayamyagam Lalitambika
One word about the sangatis that he added to the compositions. No doubt that he did adhere to the skeletal That is whatever the notation is given in the Sangita Sampradaya Pradarshini. It doesn't carry as many Sangatis as my guru sang now. But these are all added by him. He used to say, you should meditate upon every Sangati before you add it to the composition. Meditate upon. That is the word, dhyana. Then it reveals within yourself whether it is suited for the composition or not. Once you add it to the composition should accept it with pleasure, not reject it with pain. In Kannada, he used to say, vadi bardu, vadiyodu, kick it out. The composition should not kick out the sangati that you want to add. It should accept it. So that's the kind of commitment to the notation also you could see in him. So the aesthetic sense should be the deciding factor. Now we move on to the Kalpanaswara, the different aspects of his music we are taking one after the other. The Kalpanaswaras, just listen to that in first speed. Sense of the term, it is Kalpana Swara, not Kalpita Swara. Not tailored, not homemade, not practiced. Just very spontaneous Sadhyojata. It just comes on the stage. And look at the Raga Bhava, how it comes in every note. It is for a Pallavi, Marakatamani Shyamam. The second one is in Raga Gaula. Not with no design, with no deliberate pattern, but every note is so clearly heard. The notes are like pearl-like dew drops settled on the petals of a freshly blooming flower in the morning sun. Or I can also compare them to the clusters of stars sparkling in the clear sky devoid of clouds. So this is how I put it. And there is one more in the second speed. And coming to the Niraval. Niraval is to elaborate a line of Sahitya in a logical progression in the raga. beautifully it should blossom, and it does. And here is a very beautiful piece of Simhendra Madhyama, Pannagendra Shayana. His own way of, it is very tradition bound, but not conventional. Just observe. Exodus of original Sangatis emerging. It is propelled by an inner thrust and thirst for exploring the beauty of the Sahitya. So that is how it comes out, just like that. Pallavi, Ragatanam Pallavi, as far as I understand, he was not very keen or very passionate about singing Pallavis. Nevertheless, he sang very rare, Pallavis, very rare Pallavis, and in very rare Thala and different Eduppus. And I was fortunate once to accompany him in Kukke Subramanya when he presented a lecture demonstration on very rare Pallavis with different Eduppus. So in one Adi Thala, starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10 in the Anagata, Matras. And then Atita, and then Nade, Rette, all Pallavis were demonstrated in a two-hour program. So he would do it with full justice to every aspect of Pallavi. Just one sample of the Bhairavi Marakata Manishyamam, how he did the Trikalam. The turn to the wine minister.
Come on,
I told you, it is traditional but not conventional. Again, here we can observe that. He does the keel kalam, and actually he has allowed the violinist to play that. So we have edited that. And then takes up the kalam, the hasa, sings a few lines of niraval, and then takes up the second speed, male kalam. So everything is so natural and on the spot. Therefore, people can take it. So all your expectations will be set aside. Like, you know, you don't feel like willing suspension of doubt, willing suspension of expectation. It is. So everything comes, even if it comes as a surprise, it's a very pleasant surprise. So that is how he used to take it. And then we have him as the tune smith. Okay? Yeah. He had a very, very deep understanding of the musical potential of any lyric given to him. Give him any lyric, he will know how much music it can take, what kind of music it can take, and which raga it can take, what should be the tala, whatever be the chandas. Because in music, when you are setting to tune, all these things have to be taken care of. The chandas, it is quite elastic in Carnatic music. A five-lettered word can be spread across two avartas of a rupaka also. That can be done. But one has to have a very keen sense of that aesthetics while doing it. And RKS sir has set to tune how many? I really cannot keep a count of it. It is countless. Innumerable songs he has set them to tune. And each one is again a brilliant gem. Gem-like. He has excelled in setting them to tune. I should say the songs are honored by his music. They are honored by his music, and they remain green forever. And we are playing three such songs now, just a bit of each. We cannot play the whole song, though we wish to. Samsaradalli. It's a song with profound meaning. Hange irabeku samsaradalli. Purandaradasa is asking us, men on earth, to accept things as they come. Hange irabeku. You should be thus as you are destined to be. Whatever is written on your forehead. Lalata likhitam rekham brahmanapi pramashtum na shakyate. Even Brahma cannot change it. He writes it only once, I believe. Hange baredito prachinadalli. And for which very beautiful stanzas are added. The first one he sang was Pakshi angaladalli bandu kulitante. Just as a bird comes and perches on one of the tree branches of the tree, whatever, in your courtyard. Hak pakshi angaladalli bandu kutante. It is like that. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆ ಕ್ಷಣದಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾರಿ ಹೋದಂತೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಹೀ ಫ್ಲೈಸ್ ಅವೇ. ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಹಿಮ್ ವೈ ಯು ಕೇಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವೈ ಯು ಆರ್ ಫ್ಲೈಯಿಂಗ್ ಅವೇ? ದೀಸ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಆನ್ಸರ್ಡ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ಟ್ಯೂನ್ ದಿಸ್, ಹಾಗೆ ಇರಬೇಕು, ಹಾಗೆ ಇರಬೇಕು, ಹಾಗೆ ಇರಬೇಕು, ಹಾಗೆ. ಹಿ ಡಸ್ ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್, ಇರಬೇಕು ಸಂಸಾರದಲ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲಿರಿಕ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಹೆರೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಇಟ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, this is a very sprightly
mare venkat shaila vallava korajabeku yanna mare venkat shaila vallava korajabeku yanna mare venkat shaila vallava korajabeku yanna.
What a beautiful sangati.
mare venkat shaila vallava ಕುರಿತ ದೂರ ನೀನಲ್ಲದ ಧರೆಯಲು ಕುರಿತ ದೂರ ನೀನಲ್ಲದ ಧರೆಯು ಪರೆ ಮರಣ ಕಾಯಿ ನಾಡೆ ಅರಿತ ದೂರ ನಲ್ಲದ ಧರೆಗಳು ಪರೆ ಮರಣ ಕಾಣೆ ಹರೆ ವೆಂಕಟ ಶೈಲ ವಲ್ಲಭ ಕೊರಜಬೇಕು ಜನ್ಮ.
ಹಾಂ, ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಯು ವುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಹರ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್ 100 ಟೈಮ್ಸ್, ಎನಿ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್. ಅವರ್ ಎಮ್ ಎಸ್ ಅಮ್ಮ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲರೈಸ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೋ ಮಚ್, ಬಟ್ ಮೆನಿ ಮೇ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ನೋಯಿಂಗ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸಾಂಗ್ ವಾಸ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಟು ಡ್ಯೂನ್ ಬೈ ಮೈ ಗುರು.
ನಾರಾಯಣ ನಿನ್ನ ನಾಮದ ಸ್ಮರಣೆ ಸಾರಾಮೃತವು ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೆ ಬರಲಿ. ನಾರಾಯಣ ನಿನ್ನ ನಾಮದ ಸ್ಮರಣೆ ಸಾರಾಮೃತವು ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೆ ಬರಲಿ. ನಾರಾಯಣ
just tip of the iceberg of all the musical aspects. Now coming to his lecture demonstrations, they were always studded with information based on through his experience. So both it combined, and he was so meticulous in planning whether it be a concert or a lecture demonstration or a mere lecture on any given topic. He would be thoroughly prepared and he would write down each and every point. No chance. Wouldn't take any chance of missing anything. No regrets later on. So everybody used to look forward to his lecture demonstrations at various conferences. We have just two bits of that. One is Sadharana Gandhara.
ಅಂತಲೇ ಹಾಡಬೇಕು. ರಿಷಭ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಗಾಂಧಾರಕ್ಕೆ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಗಮಕ.
ಸಗ ಸಿನ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ರಿಷಭ,
ಷಡ್ಜು ಸಂಬಂಧವಾಗಿ ಮಧ್ಯಮ ಸಂಬಂಧವಾಗಿ ಆ ಗಾಂಧಾರ ನುಡಿಯುತ್ತೆ. ಅದು ಸಾಧಾರಣ ಗಾಂಧಾರವೇ. ಸನಿರವ ಮಗ ರೀಸ, ಇದು ಧನ್ಯಾಸಿರಾಗದ ಗಾಂಧಾರ ಸ್ವರೂಪ. ನೋಡಿ, ನೀ ಸಗ ಮಪಗ ಧಾಪಗ ಪಗ ಧನ್ಯಾಸರಾಗಿದೆ ಸಂಚಾರ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ. ನಿಸಗ ಮಪ ಮಪಗ ಧಾಪ ಮಪಗ
ರವೆ.
ಹಾಗೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಸಗಮಪ ಅಂತ ಹಾಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ ನಾನು. ಮಧ್ಯಮ ಸಂಬಂಧವಾಗಿಯೇ ಗಮಕಯುಕ್ತವಾಗಿ ಸಾಧಾರಣ ಗಾಂಧಾರವನ್ನು ಧನ್ಯಾಸರಾಗಿ ಹಾಡಬೇಕು.
ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಒನ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಎನ್ ಅದರ್ ಬಿಟ್ ಇನ್ 5 minutes. ಓಕೆ ಸರ, ಎನಫ್. ನೌ ದ ಸಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಶ್ರುತಿ ಶುದ್ಧ, ರಾಗ ಶುದ್ಧ, ಲಯ ಶುದ್ಧ, ಸಾಹಿತ್ಯ ಶುದ್ಧ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಭಾವ ಶುದ್ಧ. ಸೊ ಪಂಚಾಂಗ ಶುದ್ಧ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನೇಟ್. ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್ ಡಿಸಿಪ್ಲಿನೇರಿಯನ್. ವೆದರ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ರೆಡಿ ಫಾರ್ ಎ ಕಾನ್ಸರ್ಟ್, ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಎ ಆರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಎ ಆರ್. ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಫಾಲ್ ಇನ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಸಚ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್ ಡಿಸಿಪ್ಲಿನೇರಿಯನ್. And he would enjoy good food also, anything good, good company, good food, everything. He enjoyed everything, every bit of it to its full. And for such an artist, accolades do not come, very few. It is always immeasurable. So the awards that he won, I mean, there is a full 2-page list of awards in this book. He joined the galaxy of Sangita Kalanidhis in the year 1995. And Padma Bhushana was awarded to him in 2011. Padma Bhushana. Look at my Guru Mata. She is here and she is here. And she has been the inspiration and support through his life and musical career. He always used to say that she is my first critic and reviewer. So that's the kind of very sweet dampatya and the family of 7 children, 2 sons and 5 daughters. The eldest daughter, Ratnamala Prakash, is a very big name in Sugama Sangeeta. And the legacy continues. He has a huge bandwagon of disciples, overflowing, I should say, in fact. And his son, illustrious son, Ramakant, Vidushi M.S. Sheila, and a very, very big host of any number, I should say, of highly talented, eminent disciples who have made a big name in the field across the globe. The Druti Deepti Vikasa in his music, emerging from a combination, perfect blend of Ghana and Naya. Wherever it has to be supple, subtle, delicate, it takes that shape. It's like an amoeba. And wherever it needs to be hard and masculine, it does that. It's a very rare kind of music you have. And I call him proudly repository of Karnataka Sangeeta, RKS. And last, if I have 2-3 minutes time, just I would like to say how in the Sangeeta Samayasara of 13th century AD, you have 5 types of musicians: the Kutakara, Shikshaka, Bhavaka, Ranjaka, and Bhavaka, Kutakara, Shikshakara, Kutakara. So my guru was not a kutakara. Kutakara is a one who can ape, who can imitate others. He never did because he had his own style. The other 4, he said, some people may be a shikshaka, some people may be a ranjaka, or some people may be a rasika or a bhavaka. My guru was all four combined together. What does it say? Shikshakara is Kritam Vagyaya Karena Drutam Grinhati Aluptakam Avismaran Savadhana Shikshakarasa Kathyatam. Whatever the composer has composed, this person is able to grasp it at one go and retain it with all its glory and all its essential factors and then pass it on to the next generation. That is a Shikshakara and he is a Shikshakara. Rasahanau cha sandhatte nirbhave bhavamanayet alankaradi vaidyagdhyat bhavaka sobhidhiyate. Where there is no rasa, he brings in rasa. Where there is no bhava, he brings in, infuses it with bhava, with all embellishments, alankadi vaidyagdhyat, with his brain. So art is where the heart and head meet. So that is bhavaka. And then, Shrotrinam Hridayam Gyatva Tesham Chittanusarataha Gayan Ranjayate Yastu Saranjaka Itismrataha. He would feel the pulse of the audience and whatever would fit in there for that occasion, that audience, with that Pakavadya and all that, he would fashion it out and present it. That is a Ranjaka. And beautiful, the last one. Snigdham Atmashrutim Shrutva. He will get lost in his own Atmashruti. Brisham Ananda Bhag Bhavet. He will be horripilated, thrilled. Pulakankita sarvango gata sa rasika smritaha. So these four, a combination of all these. And some are experts in presenting the art themselves. Shlishta kriya kasyachid atma samstha. Some people will have that very, great expertise in performing. They will be performing artists. Sankranti Ranyasya Vishesha Yukta. There may be some, a few others who can pass it on to, transfer it to their next generation or the shishyas. Yasya Ubhayam Sadhu. The one who combines in himself both these qualities. One who is a performer at the same time a preceptor. Yasya Ubhayam Sadhu Sashikshakanam Dhuri Pratishthapayitavyayeva. He alone can be placed at the head of teachers. So that was my guru. Thank you all very much. And lastly, I'll be failing in my duty if I don't introduce my very, very dear and very senior student, Shilpa Shashidhar, Vidushi Shilpa Shashidhar, a brilliant performer, vocalist, an engineer, and who has helped me in editing the program. And also my grateful thanks goes to Srimati Ranjani Govind, who has brought out this book after a thorough research for 3 years. Her assiduous efforts have seen this book come out, even as my guru was alive. So 14th January 2014, this was released and my guru passed away. He left his mortal self on 17th February, the same year, 2014. He is physically not present with us today, but his immortal music continues its unending journey through space and time. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Sathyavathi. I think your presentation was as mellifluous as the music that was presented, and it was, I think, a worthy portrait of your guru. Thank you so much. Thank you. I now throw it open to comments. If anybody has anything to add to from their personal experience, members of the, we have a hierarchy through which we go. Members of the experts committee, Sangita Kalanidhi, Srimati Aruna Sairam, you've come for the first time today, so may we request you to please begin.
What a great guru and what a great disciple in you, Sathyavathi Amma. When we hear you speak and when we hear you sing, we can see how your guru has inspired you and at what stature he was to have produced a legion of such great disciples. Very, very moving, very touched. And all the examples you gave and all the quotes that you gave only embellished more and more the rare qualities of R.K. Srikantan ji. And we are really blessed. I particularly came here today because I did not want to miss your lecture.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, I was just coming to Sangita Kala Acharya Srimati Nagamani Srinath.
Srikantan is, he was Bhishma of Carnatic music, and then he was very much interested and well follower of even my guru Krishnan's style also. He is ardent lover of Krishnan's style, Ramnad Krishnan. So many times he has told with me, and whatever the lecture demonstration or concert, anything, Sathyavathi always, she is a brilliant artist from, so the full account of about RKSR she has given. Wonderful presentation, Sathyavathi. Really,
thank you.
Had,
yeah. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Sangita Kala Acharya Srimati Nagamani Srinath. I'll come to you, Professor. Members of the Executive Committee, anybody? Nothing? Then I pass it on to Srimati Sandhya Vinjamuri Giri, after which we will come to Professor Mysore Subramanian.
Namaskaram, everybody. I'm Sandhya Vinjamuri, daughter of Vinjamuri Vadrajengar. My association, actually my father's association with the Srikantan sir goes way back, because R.K. Venkatram Sastri has played quite a few concerts for my father. And recently my two nieces who are here, Smita and Sweta, learned from him. And my association with him, it was in Los Angeles, USA, and I was there. And his daughter Vijaya was my friend. And he used to admire my father very much. And therefore, every single year, he came to USC, he came to my house, and he, you know, I used to host a lunch or dinner for him and his family. My Trayamma came, Ramakant came, and Vijaya, of course, and Indrani also the last year.
Thank you. Thank you. So, can we now give the mic to Professor Mysore Subramania, please?
I know Dr. R.K. Srikantan from several decades, or I can say from my childhood, just like a part of his family. He was a guiding lamp to all the music practitioners. We had presented to him also Veena Session Swarmurthy V.N. Rao Memorial Award also. But through the lecture demonstration of Sathyavathi, I feel Srikantan is alive and he is here now. And secondly, Sathyavathi, I can say this is the best Guru Dakshina you can give to your Guru. Thank you.
Thank you so much. I now hand over the mic to Sangita Kalanidhi designate Dr. Soumya for her summation.
Sri Gurubhyo Namaha, Satsadaska Namaskaram, Perivallarku Enudi Namaskaram. இன்றைக்கி காளிதாசன் அவர் இருந்தார்னா எப்படி எப்படி அவருடைய ஒவ்வொரு காவியம் த போயிட்ரி த காவியாஸ் த வே ஹி என்ஜாய்ட் சம்ஸ்கிருதா த வே ஹி என்ஜாய்ட் அவர் சம்ஸ்காரா த இன்யூமரபிள் வேஸ் இன் விச் ஹி ப்ராட் அவுட் இன் ஃபார்ம் ஆஃப் போயிட்ரி காவியா இஸ் வாட் வி ஹர்ட் ஃப்ரம் டாக்டர் ஸ்ரீமதி விதுஷி சத்யவதிமா. It was so beautiful. It was like sometimes listening to the poetry, you know, about Sri Vidwan, Sri R.K. Srikantan sir, Mama, wherein you brought in so many lovely poetic references or beauty, the way you brought in. Sometimes it was kavya, sometimes it was reference, sometimes the shadangas of Veda, you said, like chandas and shiksha, and it was so beautiful, Amma. Even otherwise, I mean, for us, at least for me, I have not seen or heard many of the legends in life, in person. But here, we had such great fortune to be born a little earlier at least, you know, to listen to such great Vidwans and learned so much from that. And to hear it from you in such a beautiful way. And a great singer yourself, because I know, having learned what a meticulous person you are, having learned the compositions of Mysore Maharaja, it was such a wonderful experience, so I can see what it must have been to learn from him. That was just tip of the iceberg, blessed. I think. It was so nice. Just a few points on, as a student, that maybe all of us, so many of us are here, that we should understand. She used the word, he was a continuous learner. He was a seeker and he amassed knowledge and not wealth. She used the word amassing.
Yes.
We usually use it for
wealth.
Wealth. Here she said he amassed, he went everywhere. I'm reminded of my own Guru. I mean, they're all such great people who were constant learners. Learning was a continuous process for them. Concert was the last form of music for them. And then we talk of voice. This, all of us, many of my colleagues and many of the younger generation, we always say, whenever we talk of a voice, that crystal clear voice with that shudhi shudham and palichina padrathu abdingarathu, in that octave mele pohumbodhu, one go, but it's like complete akaram, no falsettos, and it will not be shouting also. No. That was, as a student, that I learned. What a fantastic thing. And the male, avadi palichinu poi ninna and the gandharathla ninnarna shuthi shuthamo irukku adu kattra madriyum irukadu aan akarathla paadradhu adu dhaan the alapana. In fact, if we had noticed keenly all the alapanas, none of them had this unnecessary tadana or no ri or so many things that we hear today. And I have been attending, I mean, like concert I do, even otherwise every year, anybody who sings. But those things are not there. They are all there to camouflage one's, I think, inadequacies. I think we should get over it and try to, I understand, Amma, that voice is certainly naturally given and all that. But for us to maintain what is given to us, I think these are a must. That we should really not adopt to such things and not go behind such things. And how beautiful it was every time. And the Mohanathalala, we say, you know, Nishadam Kekardi. He also sang so many Spurita, so many Ravajadis there. Gara. The speed with which he sang without that Nishada touch at all is something I think we should all understand and hear in great detail. The Sahana, that was such a beautiful Pada Sangati. Tadarana is what we hear. Na, na, na. What a beautiful Sangati that was. In fact, Sriram, I think, is not here now. I don't know. He just left. We immediately, yeah, he has a concert, but we were like, wow, for a minute. The enunciation of words, you said, very true. Sometimes in order to bring in the bhava, we tend to do things, and all, you know, we tend to sing all that to usher in that extra thing. But here he was completely at ease with that and bringing that bhava, yet the clarity of the words, really. I mean, I romba enjoy pannina adnal ungaloda pagirundukuren as a student avladha adu paadumbodhu onnonu paadrache and the yo nummi adumalla illama dhyana menala and sangathi alaga vandurthu. What more do you want? That's what we are aiming for. As she said, Bhavaka, Ranjaka, ellam chonna avat. So beautiful. And Sangati is with a purpose. Wow. I remember my own guru saying, Ramananu Brora, he in fact took a chumma ordrava cholumbodhi, he said, now make a note of Sangati's. It aedhi kongo notation, which he never says. I'm wondering why he said it. Then he went on to sing 1, 1A, 1B, 2A, 2B, 2C until 20, 22 and all that. Then he said, now what is the purpose? Then even yesterday I was talking about Telileru Rama. He said there is a purpose to the Sangatis. It shouldn't be just an exercise. So, and that was beautifully illustrated by her today. Reasserted, reaffirmed that is the way to go. That's the way to learn. So beautiful. Another thing which I would please request all my younger colleagues and music students to understand is the way he sang the Kalpanaswaram, whether be it the lower, the Vilambakala or the Drutakala, there is no unnecessary alapana there. Whatever he sang, that Bhairavi, that had so much Bhairavi in it. We don't have ni sari sari ni. I mean, that was not there. Everything he sang was just Bhairavi. So why, I don't know, because I've heard again elders say, if it is an alapana of that ragam, that has its characteristic features. If it is a kalpanaswaram, that has its features. So you're looking at the same raga from a different perspective every time, as a niraval, as a swaram. But why unnecessarily combine the two? That was such a beautiful illustration. That was really, Amma. That is amazing. As a Renjama, romba enjoy pannina adala. I keep thinking, and there it is for us to take it, or served on a silver platter today. So beautiful. And the chinna short avartanas of swarams, especially in ragas like Darbar, nobody's joke or play it is. It's so beautiful to learn, understand the ragas. I think we as students should definitely take, you know, a lot of leaves or take the book itself to understand all these. And Nirval, the placement of Sahitya on dot, oh no, no. And actually, I'm just reiterating for my younger colleagues here, not to this thing, you're this thing, Amma. It's just that many of them here, some people came late. So thank you so much, so much, so much for this enriching experience. It's been so beautiful. One last thing is, again, this year's every presentation on any Ella Perivala Patiyu in the Indavati in the presentations were all so beautiful. And today was no exception. It was a crowning glory. Thank you.
Thank you.